everyone, Mike from Good Day for Decay. As you can see behind me, all the nice Halloween decorations behind me. Today, I'm at Jones Marketplace. So it's on Route 307. It's gonna be up in Springbrook Township. And right across the street is Jones Auction House. They have a lot of different auctions going on. I believe she was saying about one of the hugest blow mold auctions around in the country ends up being right there at Jones Auction House. So I'm gonna switch this around and we're gonna get inside. There's a lot of antiques here. I caught this just because we were going to lunch one day and driving by, I didn't even realize. I thought it was just an old farmhouse. Come to realize, no, it's not. It's actually, it's collectibles and antiques and you name it in there. So I'm gonna give you a sneak peek. I won't be too long, hopefully, but there's a lot of stuff in there, I know that. So I'm gonna try to show you as much as I can without, you know, boring anybody. And if you've seen stuff in there before, maybe you had it as a kid, maybe you still have it, leave it in the comments. Put down the timestamp when it was. All right, guys, with further ado, let's flip this around. Let's get inside, let's go. All right, guys, this is out front. This is out front of the marketplace here. I believe what it is, they have different sellers selling stuff in here, if I understood correctly. So they have different sections for different people, and they have on the back of the tags that they're selling is their number, kind of like a consignment shop kind of deal, it sounds like. So they bring stuff in, that's how they make their money. They are having an event here, cornhole and whatnot over the weekend. It is Halloween weekend. And I was told that a lot of this stuff here that you see was purchased from a haunted attraction. And I believe the haunted attraction was Dracula's Forest. That closed down a few years ago, I believe. The old casket. And it's gonna be, they're gonna plan on trying to do hay rides. Hopefully next year, do some hay rides for the kids. This weekend they're going to have a band. They're trying to get their name out. So I figure, why not? I like that huge guy flying in the air. Why not try to help these guys? Let's get their name out there. Definitely got to come check this place out. My God, I love him. I think the wolf's got him. He doesn't look pretty. I'm gonna flip you around now. Across the street is their auction house. They have the auctions over there. So it's definitely check out the store, the auction house. Like one of the largest blow mold auctions in the country is held over there. And it's next weekend. Well, depending on when I get this video out, it might have passed, but I'm hopefully get the video out this week while I'm on vacation. Like the mannequin leg there. So we're gonna make our way in and we're gonna start this journey inside their store. You guys ready? Don't be scared. Gotta remember the old NAS. I just bought one recently. That one's Popeye. Ben Cooper, where you would just put the plastic cape on. I just bought Bo Luke, and I actually have Boss Hogg as well. As you guys know, I'm a Dukes of Hazzard fan. All right, guys. Well, you know what time it is. Let's go inside. All right, everyone, we just got inside of Jones Marketplace. Lots of antiques and collectibles. I was here probably about a month ago, and there is so much to see. Now they own, the Jones Auction House, which is across the street. I'll try to capture as much as I can here. There is a lot of stuff. Before I'm done, I'll get the hours. I'm not sure what winter hours they're having. And I remember checking, like, a lot of the stuff I've seen in either abandoned places or I've owned. Or I've seen before. Some stuff I've never seen, like these little tin toys, never saw that before. Some coins. So they're nice enough to let me do a video in here. They opened October 2021. That is pretty cool. That is gorgeous. As you guys know, I collect anything Dukes of Hazzard, so if there is something here, I'm gonna find it. I know I've saw they had an auction recently over there, and there was some Dukes of Hazzard memorabilia over there, but I never got to get up to it. They have a lot of coin sets, stamps, so you can get different proof sets right there. There's some gold stamps, different watches. I believe we had one of those turnstiles when I was a kid. And This is definitely a little place you want to check out. It's kind of like this little hidden gem. I drove by, I didn't even realize it was in a little marketplace, antique store. And they actually had outside, they were doing, they had tents set up outside. So that's the only reason I really stopped. I really didn't even take notice that I just thought it was an abandoned house, and come to realize this house is packed full of antiques for sale. I believe that's for her deviled eggs. Some cassettes. Titanic. And some blow molds. Oh, Santa. Like the mushroom ottoman there. That's pretty cool with the ladder up there. Then hanging stuff up there. Oh, we still have that guy right there, the Charles Chips. I think my dad has that. It's an old scale. Computer figures. Actually, that orange juice one, it's something like that I just saw on one of the abandoned houses. Baseball cards as a kid. John Crook, go Phillies. They just made it to Super Bowl. Jeez, World Series. So leave in the comments. Have you seen anything here? Put a timestamp. Maybe you still own it. It's a little coffee grinder. Bean grinder right there. Pumpkin. I like that. There's poo. collector's scale. Like that cyan Cadillac. Definitely a lot of hockey stuff. Penguins. I see Tux back there. So I was told this house is the turn of the century. That they converted it. Oh my God, look at the rotary phone. It's funny watching kids try to, seen videos kids trying to operate them. They can't get it. It's an old fan, fire extinguisher. Never saw one like that before. The old ice cube tray where you crack and break the ice. It's a nice shape. Where's this from? It doesn't say. An old amusement park. Snow speedster. The hornet's nest. Here, because there's a little entranceway here. I love seeing this, all this old stuff. Games. So if you're in the Scranton, Wilkes-Barre area, you definitely have to come check this out. Definitely a pretty cool place off the beaten path here. You don't see stuff like this anymore. Some old trains, tin trains, oh, firehouse. Plasticville, we have that. So much of this stuff brings back memories of maybe you have it or used to have it. And this is only the downstairs. I didn't even get to the upstairs. I know there's more things upstairs. I think majority is down here, but oh my God, we have that Kung Fu hamster. You still in the box? Oh, little Tommy Pickles. I picked him right out. Some of the matchbox. Some nice reeds up there. Okay, I'm gonna go make my way back over here. I'm gonna head upstairs next. I like the straw log cabins there, all made out of straws. I would never have the patience to build something like that, that's for sure. Hootie and the Blowfish. Definitely a lot of stuff I have never seen. Lifesavers, that is a big lifesaver can. It's like, it looks maybe like a garbage can. It's pretty big. The old Halloween bucket. I think we had one, something like that. Genesee sign. Something to that nature. Pretty close to it. I've never seen that before. Mega roll. We're gonna make our way upstairs. I know the staircase is loaded with Red Barons. Scranton Red Barons, not around anymore. Now it's, it changed names now. So we're gonna make our way upstairs. This is all filled with comics and different kinds of books through the staircase. I think there was, if I'm not mistaken, I've seen records. There's some bunch of different things I like this. Ammo and service. Right up my alley there. Well, you can sit here and look and look and look. Put the old cards up there. Means you ain't gonna show. If you look out your window tonight. Definitely, oh look, I like the crow. Edward Scissorhands. Definitely, Ronald McDonald. I know I can't get everything here. Bullwinkle supermarket game, board game. It's pretty neat how they have everything pinned up. They didn't pin it, they pinned the cardboard that, like they didn't pin the book itself. It's not damaged. They pinned around it, so it's pretty cool. I know I can't get everything. There's just so many. Welcome to Honesdale. See some Nightmare Before Christmas back there. I see Zero, he's right there. There's another, what is that? Oh, Freddy Krueger. Taz is back there, I see. Referring to doggies, you got some collies there. Small ones are 10, and the large ones are 15. Look at that camera. That is pretty cool. Is that supposed to be Aunt Jemima? Nope. Oh, Mammy. Oh, Pinocchio. Wedding dresses. Very nice setup. They have all the rooms set up separately. Avon colognes. For grinding your drugs or prescriptions. Look at that. Wood rasp.
As a burger topping, or putting espresso in your milkshake, or picking up $65 worth of fried food curbside.
There is so much to see here. They did a very nice job. This is amazing. They did a great job displaying everything.
Make a convenience store of your new favorite hangout spot.
Sick of your car? Looking for a Kia? The biggest selection of new Kias are at Performance Kia on Burney Avenue in Moosic. Call 866-KIA-KINGS or visit PerformanceKIAPA.com.
Northeast PA's classic rock 107 and the Romantics.
Yeah, this will probably have a few copyrights on it with the music on, but it is what it is. It's not like I'm doing it. I'm just doing it for entertainment here. I love helping people out. And showing what's out there in the world. So, definitely gonna have some copyrights banging on mine, but it is what it is. I can't really go too much into detail in every room, or this will be an hour video. I don't wanna make too long of a video. With reindeer, like 97 cents. American Auto, my God, my dad used to talk about American Auto all the time. That's where all our Christmas gifts came from, was American Auto. Like I said originally, I'll take a shot out the back. So they have a tent and stuff set up out back. When I came the last time, they actually had in the backyard was filled with tons and tons of stuff as well. And don't forget to check out their auction house, which is called Jones Auction House. Nice. Oh, she's awesome. She's awesome.
Would you like some drink? Or would you have some drink?
She is awesome.
The candy is special. I made it myself. Just for you.
Guys, well, I'll go outside, I'll wrap this up.
You make it sick.
I'll do, give you my thoughts as soon as I get outside, and I'll show you a little more of the outdoors as I'm doing as well. Guys, let's go. All right, guys. Well, that was your look inside Jones Marketplace. Definitely a really cool place. Come check it out. It's on Route 307. Right across the street is their auction house. So definitely a place you want to see. If you had stuff as a kid, if you have stuff now that you saw in there, put it in the comments. Tell me what you think. If you need any information, please feel free to send me a message, leave me a comment. I'll get back to you. I'll give you the exact location. I will have the exact location in the description down below. If you've never been here, please come here. I don't know what winter hours they have right now, but it is getting close to the end of the season, but you gotta check this place out. It is really cool. Again, guys, comment, like, subscribe, make sure you ring that notification bell. That'll let you know when I have a video that just came uploaded. Guys, I'll catch you on my next adventure. See ya!